First horse on course, Karen Lundy and Prince Panache riding for the USA. Her dressage score is 60.2. And we're going to have Andy down there in the vet box to let us know what's going on.
So the chain of events that are going to start taking place here in a minute is we're going to see Karen's horse arrive here. And the horse will then be presented to the grand jury. The horse's temperature, pulse and respiration will be taken. And a note will be taken of those vital statistics. The horse will also be allocated a timer. Now this person is going to be responsible for clocking your horse's time during this 10-minute period. It's your job to ensure to know who that timer is, as you'll want to be made aware of the time as it elapses. It's a good idea to have the person that's going to stand down here, and in fact here we have Karen now, so we're actually going to follow Karen through the process of the 10-minute box. And you can see Karen trotting the horse in to display the soundness of the horse. The horse still looking very fresh and sound. A visual inspection was made of the shoes as the horse came in. And now as we see the helpers placing the thermometer in and the veterinarian, Dr. Barbara Forney, taking the horse's heart rate. Now you can see how rapidly everybody's moving around the horse, but they're still moving very calmly and efficiently, ensuring that not to excite the horse. A cooler's been placed on the horse to keep the rear end warm and also a rain sheet over the top.
Well, we first committed an hour on course.
We can see Paul loosening the noseband, and a head collar and lead rope has been placed on the horse.
Thanks, Andy. And Karen now down to fence four, the ditch and brush.
Well, the first three fences, they gave you time to get up on your feet. And now this is the first combination you ride. She left it out in two and one. That's a good sign. It's early in the course, but that's a good sign that the horse is really, you know, focused. That was your first question.
Is that a related distance or is that?
Well, there is a related distance there, but, you know, when you're jumping a ditch in a brush like that, who knows?
And, of course, that big line here to these two very big outs.
Yes, and that I think, is gonna, you know, I would think would cause some, that's a directional problem, and I would think it would cause some problems in this weather later on. Because, again, you don't know how they're going to respond, whether you're going to do four strides or a direct three to this, and then after that you come to that big vertical gate, and it's really raining now, so I mean going early might be to an advantage here, because at least you get some of this old sod and turf. So I think if I was riding, I'd rather go early and get it done before the course begins.
So this is going to be a big question throughout the day, how much stud you're going to need, how much feet, and there's a lot of big open gallops here.
Well, and that's good towards the end because they threw a lot at you early on. That fence you just saw, their jump, in fact, because of the weather, they put the takeoff rail in front of it. From this angle, it didn't look like a lot, but it was quite a big vertical with a drop behind it, and it didn't naturally ditch in front. Here she's coming to, I know a lot of riders are worrying whether they're going to get one or two. She pushed for the one. You saw that mare was game. She really reached for it, but the principle was, Karen stuck with her program. She really rode strong to it. That was a big effort, and I know a lot of people are watching to see what's going to happen there.
And down to this frog pond, which is just a kind of a vertical into a pond.
But it's still very open down there so far.
Well,
so
and the saving grace behind it is some of the horse was a little cautious there, but the right kind of cautious was that there was a takeoff rail in front of it, so that helped.
Okay, down to 16 through 19 now. Called the Serpent. There's five jumping efforts in here.
Yeah, this is when we walked the course with Mark Phillips, as he said, this is a four-star question, and this is a three-star event. And she's, you know, this mare is, you know, the first two were, she was really working. Now she's, you know, she made it look easy for the way that fence was designed. I guess that's what I'm trying to say. It's going to ride tough all day long.
Yeah, those are like 10-meter turns left and right. Twist and move, and nice over this boat dock.
Yeah, I mean, really nice, and I'm surprised they didn't put an option going in. You know, you have to jump that log. All horses are going to look awkward over it.
Bruce Davidson with Heyday now, riding for the USA, a score of 58.4 to start his day off.
When conditions are a little bit more friendlier and the weather's a bit warmer, all the equipment you see in the back of us would be laid out on the ground in clear view. Obviously, it's not practical to do that today because of the weather conditions, but you can see how the buckets have been placed at a distance from the tack trunks, and therefore the horse can be walked through. Now we're seeing a stud change being done.
Grant Snyderman going very well. The Pathfinder is over the Tidworth at 21.
And you notice how calm everybody is around this horse. And Debbie, they're just giving those studs an extra turn to ensure that nothing comes loose on the next phase, which is the cross country.
Sponsored by All States Grabbing Services. That's 24 and 25. 25 in the dog.
Grease now being applied. The grease compound that Bruce uses is a special type of water-soluble medicated cream. It's important to make sure that you don't touch anything else once you've applied this grease, as you don't want grease on the reins or the stirrups. Again, now you'll watch Debbie look around for a nice, clear, flat spot, and the horse will be jogged now for the veterinarians to ensure soundness to continue.
And continue we will, down to fence four, now on course, Bruce Davidson and Heyday.
Well, this is one of his upcoming horses. This is a really special horse. Bruce has high expectations for it. As we all do with horses coming along, but this horse we watched go at Essex in the spring, and this is going to be a really nice one. Now this, you see how he gave this horse time because of the footing?
Little slip?
Yeah, it was a little slip. That's the way it's going to ride, but he opted to jump straight, whoa, then make the turn. And here he comes. He's taking a little bit of a longer route here because of the footing and this being in the woods. He decided to give take a little bit of extra time here, so that the horse didn't slip and make a mistake early in the game. And that's important with, you know, especially your green horses. You don't want them to take a hard knock early so that you can open up. Here comes to one of the tougher complexes other than the serpent.
It looks like the bounce for him going here.
Yes, the way he's riding, definitely the bounce. He didn't want to take the opportunity for this green horse to make a mistake, obviously.
It looks like he's giving this horse a lot of extra support.
Well, you know, due to the conditions now, and not knowing those substantial size bounces, and there you can see now he lands and hits the throttle. You can definitely trust this horse's gallop to believe that he can make up some of the time that he's lost going to the corners. I think because of the distance being, you know, stuck between a deathly long one or a really tight two, as brave as this horse is, he decided, you know, rather than, you know, Shannon's a little more seasoned. She can make a mistake.
Oh, and he's going fast enough to fool our cameraman.
Yeah, really. And you can see it with the rain, they're starting to land into that water ditch. But again, this horse is going to be really a nice one. He jumped that narrow section on that side, and away he goes.
And this is a six-year-old owned by Dr. Eleanor Jenny from Unionville, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, and it's unusual to see something, you know, 6 years old jumping around a course like this. And look how tight he was there.
Yeah.
He just tapped a little bit behind. That's going to be probably one of the best techniques over that jump, horse-wise, if you're
six.